Hi students, friends, good afternoon to all. So in previous lecture, we have stopped our lecture at this particular point, layouts of the distribution systems. So we started this point at the end of the unit, end of the lecture. Okay. So let us begin from this slide only. So the distribution of pipes are generally, it is laid below the roads payments. रोड पेमेंटच्या खाली आपण शक्यतो आपण काय करतो वॉटर सप्लायच्या लाईन डिस्ट्रीब्युशन लाईन जे आहे ती आपण त्या ठिकाणी हे केलेली असतात कोरलेली असतात. ओके, सो दॅट्स वाय जनरली द लेआउट ऑफ द डिस्ट्रीब्युशन नेटवर्क इट फॉलोज द लेआउट ऑफ द रोड. जसं रोडचं लेआउट आहे त्याप्रमाणे त्या ठिकाणी देर विल बी अ लेआउट फॉर दिस पर्टिक्युलर डिस्ट्रीब्युशन नेटवर्क ऑर डिस्ट्रीब्युशन पाईप्स. ओके, सो अकॉर्डिंग टू द टाईप ऑफ लेआउट ऑफ द रोड्स द नेटवर्क ऑफ द distribution system it can be classified in these four categories. One is the dead end system, second one grid iron system, then third one circular or ring system, and last one is the radial system. Okay, so these systems can be designed or laid, that water distribution systems, it can be laid in one particular kind of layout, or it may be laid there in the combination of these two. Okay, so we have discussed about this one point in the previous lecture also. So now we will see each system type of the layout in details. First one is the dead end, or the it is also called as the tree system. Why it is called a tree system? Because as tree has one trunk, trunk is there, and then there from there is a main branch is there, and from that main branch again there are different sub branches are there. Okay, so likewise in this particular system there is a main pipeline, and to that main pipeline there will be connection of the sub mains. Okay, and then to that sub main there will be a connection of the laterals, branches and laterals. Okay, so as it grows or its layout is similar to the tree shape, so because of that it is also called as the tree system. You can see here in this diagram particularly, this is the main line or the main pipe which has running like this, water is flowing like this in this system. Now here you can see the notations here. M is for the main pipe, SM is for the sub main, B is for the branch pipe, and CV is for the cutoff valves. Okay, so this is the main pipeline, and to this main pipeline there is a connection of the sub mains. So there are number of sub mains have been connected to this particular main line. You can see here this is a one sub main, this is another sub main, it has been connected to this, there is another sub main here, there is another sub main, it has been connected here to this particular main pipeline. And whenever there is a change in the connections is there, or from main pipeline there is a sub main connection is there, so at every entrance of the sub main pipe there is a wall or cutoff wall has been provided there, so that we can control the flow of water inside this particular system. Okay, subsystem. So you can see there is here is wall, then here is a cutoff wall, there is also cutoff wall. Okay, so we can have access or control the flow of water in that particular subsystem. Okay, if we close this wall, water cannot enter inside this, or if we open the wall, then water will start to flow through this sub main. And to this sub main, for every sub main there is a connection of the branches. So this is a branch pipe, this is one branch, this is another branch, this is another branch pipe, this is another branch pipe. Okay, so for every connection there is a reduction in the diameter. So the diameter of this biggest diameter of the pipeline will be for the main pipe. Okay, main pipeline will have a bigger size diameter. Then as sub mains here branch out here, the diameter of the sub main will be lesser or smaller as compared to the diameter of the main pipe. Okay, then the diameter of the branch pipes will be smaller than the diameter of the sub main pipe. And to this branch pipe there is a connection of the laterals here, you can see. So this again the diameter of the laterals will be smaller than the diameter of the branch pipes. Okay, and to this laterals there will be a connection of the we can say house connection, je gharatun aalele connection asta nal aapla. So that connection will be connected to these laterals. Okay, hey, lateral la tyadikani connection jodlel asta. So this is a typical layout, and here you can see there is no regular pattern of the layout. Okay, it is a haphazardous pattern. Okay, And this is particularly useful or applicable for the old cities or the old towns where the development has not possible in a regular way or regular pattern. Okay. अशा काही सिटीज आहेत ज्यामध्ये प्लॅन व्यवस्थित प्लॅन केलेल्या तयार झालेल्या सिटी नाही आहेत. ओके, विदाउट प्लॅनिंग द सिटीज विच हॅव बीन ग्रोन टू दॅट वी कॉल यूज द वर्ड्स दॅट हॅफहॅझार्डस ग्रोथ. ओके, म्हणजे कोणत्याही डायरेक्शनमध्ये कसंही त्या ठिकाणी ग्रोथ झालेली असते. सो यू कॅन ऑब्झर्व द रोड लाईक दिस ऑल्सो. दिस इज अ यू कॅन से दिस अँड हॅव्हिंग अन इन्क्लिनेशन टू द मेन लाईन ऑर मेन रोड. So there will be a growth of the cities in a hazardous way. In that particular city, we can go for such kind of, we can say, water distribution system, that is dead end system. Again, the question might have come in your mind that why it is called as the dead end system? Why it is called? Can anyone tell me? What is the reason behind that? Why we call it as a dead end system? Yes, anyone? You can unmute and you can put your answer, tell your answers, or you can put your answers in the chat window or chat box. Why this particular system, it has been named as a dead end system? Am I audible? Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So I think nobody knows the answer. So that's why people are not giving the answer. Okay, I will tell you. See here, this particular branch, it has been ended here. There is the end of this submain. And from this submain, there is a branch here. And again, this branch has been end point here. It has an end point here. Similarly, this is a branch. This is the lateral. It has the end here. Now here in this diagram, you can observe that these ends are not connected to the main again. Okay, these ends are dead ends. Okay, ya tikani pura connection nahi hai. If this pipe has been connected to this particular submain, or if this submain branch pipe, it has been connected to this main line again like this. Okay, means what will happen? There will be a circulation of water. So there will not be dead end in this particular system, dead end system. There is a dead end, means the water cannot flow here henceforth. Yacha pudhe te vahu shakat nahi. And the end of these pipes will be closed with the help of walls, or there will be a provision of the score hole at the end of this particular pipes, so that this is the drawback actually, that dead end system. Means if there are dead ends in each pipe, then what will happen? The water will be get stagnant there. ओके, हे पाणी या ठिकाणी काय होईल? स्टॅग्नंट होईल. अँड बिकॉज ऑफ द स्टॅग्नेशन ऑफ द वॉटर, देर आर चान्सेस ऑफ पोल्युशन ऑफ द वॉटर. ओके, इफ द वॉटर रिमेन्स देअर फॉर लॉंगर टाइम, देर इज अ पॉसिबिलिटी दॅट वॉटर मे गेट डिटेरिओरेटेड, इट्स क्वालिटी विल गेट डिक्रीज. अँड दिस इज द ड्रॉबॅक ऑफ दिस डेड एंड सिस्टीम, वॉटर इज नॉट इन सर्क्युलेशन. सो इन दिस पर्टिक्युलर काइंड ऑफ सिस्टीम, वॉट द प्रोविजन हॅज टू बी मेड, द स्कोर होल्स आर वॉल्स आर टू बी प्रोवाइडेड at the edge dead end. Pratyek dead end la ya tikani score holes walls provide kar lagtil, so that the stagnated water in this particular pipe, it can be taken outside this particular pipe with the opening of this valve, water will get come out. And again, you can see there, when we score out the water from this particular pipe, there is a wastage of water, it is going to occur. That treated water will get somewhat wasted. Okay, that thing has to be done. Again, another disadvantage of this system is that if the water is coming inside this only through one single point, okay, and there is no another alternate way so that water can enter inside this particular subsystem. So whenever there is a repair work or maintenance work, it will take place there. So the this particular area or locality will not get the water for that particular period of time. Okay. जर या ठिकाणी जर काही मेंटेनन्स इश्यू असेल, ही जी सबमेन गेलेली आहे, हा सबमेनचा पाईप, हा पाईप जर या ठिकाणी कुठं ब्रेक झाला असेल, काही लिकेज असेल, इन दॅट केस ज्यावेळेस हा मेंटेनन्स आपण करायला चालू करेल, त्यावेळेस काय होईल? मग या ठिकाणी खालचे जे लाईन्स आहेत गेलेल्या, किंवा या ठिकाणी जे होम्स आहेत, दे विल नॉट गेट द वॉटर इन दॅट पर्टिक्युलर टाईम इन्स्टंट. ओके, दिस इज अनदर ड्रॉबॅक ऑफ दिस सिस्टीम. बट इन्स्टेड ऑफ दिस सिस्टीम, इफ देर इज अदर सिस्टीम्स विच आर देअर, which are closed system, means these pipes will be connected like this, so that though there is a problem at this particular point, water can reach inside this particular pipe and it can fulfill the requirement of the water in that particular system, in that particular locality. So this is another drawback of this system. The main advantage of the system is that the design of this system is quite simple. It will not take the design will be not much difficult, it will be easier, and the layout of the work will be simple. Okay, see here, whatever the things I have told you that have been explained here. From the lateral, house connections have been provided at the different houses. The system is suitable for the irregular developed towns. Yeah, city or towns as a growth ahe. If it has been irregular, haphazardously if it has grown, then in that case we have to go for such kind of system. The system of water supply, water flows in one direction only. Okay, so this is the unidirectional flow. You can see here, as water coming inside this, it will have only forward direction movement of the water. Water will move here again, and in this pipe also it will go ahead. So there is no reverse direction or reversal of the water is possible here, because it is a dead end system. The ends are not connecting back to the sub main or branch pipes, sub main pipes. Okay, so this is a unidirectional flow, you can say. The diameter of the pipes decreases at every tree branch. So I have told you, as there is a branch pipe or the sub main is coming here, so the here diameter can decrease. Again here there will be a reduction in the diameter, it will be observed, because the flow will decrease. See here, the main pipeline will contain large amount of flow, but that water has to be reached here in this particular locality, again here also. So when we open this wall particularly, so here in this particular pipe, only this much quantity of water will be supplied. So the diameter of the pipe will be reduced here in this case. Again, when the water coming from this particular this branch pipe, so this is going to fulfill the water requirement for this particular locality. So again, the diameter of the pipe is going to reduce in this particular case. Now, these are the certain advantages and disadvantages of this dead end system has been given here. Out of that, some of the disadvantages and advantages we have discussed right now. The discharge and pressure at any point in the distribution system is calculated easily. So the calculation part or design part of this particular system is somewhat easier as compared to the other system, because the direction of the flow is unidirectional. So and we can easily calculate the discharge and the pressure in this particular system. The walls required in the system of the layout are comparatively less as compared to the other systems, because in other system there is a closed circuit we have to follow. So the number of walls required will be more as compared to the other system. Okay, the number of walls requirement will be less in this particular system. The diameter of the pipes used are smaller, and hence the system is cheap and economical. So as the pipes here used will be having smaller diameter, okay, the diameter of the pipes will go on decreasing as there is a change in the pipes is there. From the main pipe, the sub main will have the smaller diameter. From sub main, the branch pipe will have smaller diameter. So as the diameters of the pipes go on decreasing, so the cost for the pipes laying will be reduced, and because of that, entire cost will be lesser, and the system will be more economical as compared to the other systems. The laying of water pipe is simple in this particular case. Disadvantage. What are the disadvantages here? So we have discussed about this stagnation water. Water becomes stagnant as there is a dead end of the pipes, causing the contamination. Then during the repairs work, valves or repairs of the pipes or the valves at any point, the entire downstream end are deprived from the supply. या पूर्णपणे पाईपचा जो वॉटर सप्लाय आहे पाण्याचा सप्लाय त्या ठिकाणी बंद होऊ शकतो. द वॉटर अवेलेबल फॉर द फायर फाइटिंग विल बी लिमिटेड इन क्वांटिटी इन दिस सिस्टम. पर्टिक्युलरली द अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ वॉटर फॉर द फायर फाइटिंग विल बी समवॉट लेस. नेक्स्ट सिस्टम इज द ग्रिड आयन सिस्टम. Now from the name itself we will get an idea. The shape or the layout of this system is the grid iron, or we can say it is a square shape, like this pattern of the pipeline distribution system will be there. Okay, the system is also called as the reticular system. In this system, one main runs through the center, and the branch and lateral runs in the grid pattern, which are interconnected as shown in figure. So now here you can see this diagram for the grid iron system. again here the nomenclature is same. Capital M is for the main pipes, SM is for the submain, B is for the branch or the laterals, and SV is for the core walls. So this is the, you can see it through the center of the total area or the city or that particular town, the main pipe has been gone like this. And to this main pipe, there are the submains, and to this submain, there are the branches and laterals have been connected. And there is a formation of a rectangular, or you can say square pattern in this layout, or we can call it as a grid iron. Okay, so this particular system, it is useful in the plan cities. So the cities which have been developed by using certain kind of plan. So generally such kinds of systems, roads patterns are visible there or observed there. So in that particular well-planned cities, such kind of water distribution systems can be implemented. So here advantage of the system is that there is a no dead end. You can see in the diagram, there is a no dead end to the pipe. So every pipe is connected to the other pipes. So you can see this is the submain pipe is there. And this submain pipe is connected with this branch pipe, and that's with the other submain. So this submain, two submains have been connected to each other by this submain, this branch pipe. Again, this submain and this submain have been connected by this branch pipe. And again, here this one. Okay, so what will happen because of this? There is a no stagnation of water is going to occur here. And because of that, no contamination of water is possible in this particular system. Then another advantage of this system is that there is circulation of water continuously. So whenever there is a maintenance issue of any particular point, let us say there is a maintenance issue of this particular submain pipe, then you may think that there will be this particular area on downstream side of this submain, it will deprive with the water. But this thing is not going to happen because this submain is going to carry the water, and this water will be supplied through this branch pipe and through this branch pipe to this particular downstream area, affected area. So there is no possibility of the deprivation or the low supply of water at any particular instant of maintenance. So this is not going to happen. Okay, so this is another advantage of this system. The disadvantage of the system is that the more diameter pipes, larger diameter of the pipes will be required here, and the more number of walls you can see here. This is one wall, there is another wall, this is another wall. So the more number of walls has to be used, and because of that, the system become more costly as compared to the dead end system. Okay. Since the pipe lines get water from the different directions, design is a bit difficult. Also, this disadvantage of the system is that the design of the system, as there is a directions of the water, flow of the water is from any direction, water may come inside this pipe. So the direction will be different. So the design is somewhat difficult to understand. The size of the pipes are larger and more number of sluice walls are to be used. So the cost will become costlier. This system is suitable, most suitable for the planned cities. So we have discussed this point here, where the roads and streets are provided in a planned rectangular or square grid pattern. And this system is also called as the interlaced system. So the MCQ question may be asked on this synonyms. What is the meaning of interlaced system, or which system is called as the interlaced system? And the option will be dead end system, then grid iron system, or remaining two systems will be there. Out of that system, we have to select appropriate answer. This system also called as the reticular system. So all these synonyms also you have to keep in mind about this particular names. Okay. Now, again, here the advantage and disadvantage have been mentioned here. Advantages, in this case, the repairs, a very small portion of the distribution will be affected. Okay. म्हणजे जरी या ठिकाणी रिपेअरची गरज पडली तरी वॉटर कॅन रीच टू दी दॅट पर्टिक्युलर डाउनस्ट्रीम पोर्शन ऑफ द दॅट लोकॅलिटी फ्रॉम द अदर साइड्स दे हॅव वी हॅव डिस्कस राईट नाउ दिस पॉइंट एव्हरी पॉइंट रिसीव द सप्लाय फ्रॉम द टू डायरेक्शन अँड विथ द हायर प्रेशर सो देर इज अ नो इश्यू ऑफ द लो प्रेशर सप्लाय ॲडिशनल वॉटर फ्रॉम द अदर ब्रांच आर अवेलेबल फॉर द फायर फायटिंग इफ देर इज अ फायर फायटिंग इश्यू एनी फायर आउटब्रेक इज देअर इन दॅट केस द मोर वॉटर विल बी अवेलेबल टू द fire extinguisher, which was not there in case of the dead end system. There is a free circulation of water, hence there is not liable for the pollution due to stagnation. So we have discussed this point. There is no stagnation of water, and hence because of the free circulation of water, the pollution of the water is not going to occur much here in this system. What are the disadvantages? more length of the pipe is required because there is no dead end. All the ends are to be connected with the system only. So the more number of pipes and more number of walls are required in the system. So because of that, cost of the construction will increase here. Calculation of the size of the pipes and the working out the pressure requirement. It is somewhat difficult, laborious, and complicated thing here. So these are the disadvantage of this grid iron system. Then third system we are going to see here is the circular or the ring system. This system contains the main pipe all around the area. The area to be served in the rectangular, square, or circular pattern. So now here, this diagram particularly we can see here. This is the diagram which shows the circular or ring system. Here the main pipeline is laid along the periphery of the town, or you can say. And this, it may be laid in a rectangular, it may be laid in a square pattern, a square shape, or it can be in circular shape, depending upon the road arrangement there. Okay, ring road, you might have heard about this. If the ring road is circular, like shape is there, or it is rectangular in shape, as the size of the roads are there, accordingly, the shape of the that particular water supply system will be like that. Okay, it may be circular, it may be rectangular, it may be square shape. And the main pipeline, it will run along the periphery of this town or this city, along this road line. And this main pipeline will be connected with the submains like this. This is another one submain, this is another submain, this is another submain. And again here, there is a submain. So there is a formation of such kinds of arrangement will occur there. And there will be a number of walls here. Again, it is a, we can say it is a closed system. As compared to the dead end system, there is no dead end in the system. Again, the same advantage we are going to get as that advantages were for the this grid iron system. Grid iron system che je kay advantage ahet tes advantage aplyala ya thikani pahayla bhetatil, teche je kay disadvantage ahet tes disadvantage aplyala ya thikani that we can observe the same disadvantage for this particular circular or ring system. You can see here advantages and disadvantages are the same as that of the grid system, except more advantage of the having more service head due to the main running all around the area. So here we can see that there is a more advantage as compared to the ring system, because in this particular grid system the main was running through the center only, but here as the main is running throughout the periphery of this system, so more head, pressure head will be available in this particular system. So this is a more one more advantage of the circular or ring system. This system is also suitable for the planned cities or the township. Okay, and the fourth system of the water supply, or you can say layout, type of the layout is the radial system. Okay, now radial system, it is applicable to the cities or the town which is very big in size. So there, what we do, we divide the total area in different zones. We prepare the, divide the entire area into the different zones. And for that particular one zone, there will be a one particular distribution tank or distribution reservoir. And from that distribution reservoir, there will be a different submains or the branch pipes will be radiating in all direction. Okay. So from the diagram, you will get some idea about that. So you can see here in this particular diagram, the entire area has been divided in different zones. In this particular diagram, you can observe there are four zones. This is one, this is second, this is third, and this is fourth. These are the four zones have been divided or created here. And for this particular zone, the water main distribution tank will be at the center of this zone. And from this particular tank, which is at the center of the this area or locality, there is a branching of the or a pipe might be you can see here, these are the pipes have been come here in the radial direction. Okay, and because of this it is called as the radial system of the supply. Okay, so M is for the main, then SM is for the submain pipe, B is for the branch, and distribution reservoir is at the center. So this is another distribution reservoir here, there is another distribution reservoir here, this is another distribution reservoir here. Okay, and from here, now here you can see this is the main pipe at the center of this area locality, and from this main pipe there is a submain pipe, and through this submain pipe water will be collected inside this distribution reservoir, distribution tank. And after filling this distribution tank, whenever there is a supply at that time, valves will be opened and water will be moved through this branch pipe which have been radiating in all directions. Okay, so this is another important or helpful system of the water supply. This is a zoned system. A big area is divided in several zones, and at the center of each zone of the distribution reservoir is kept. Okay, distribution reservoir has pratyek zone center la tya tikani thevlela asto. From each distribution reservoir, branches or the laterals radiate in all directions. So, if you have figure madhe bagitla, pratyek direction madhe ase branches kiwa sub mains yet tikani laterals he radiate zalele ahet. Water is pumped to the distribution reservoir, and from the reservoir it is flow by the gravity. So here you can see in this particular distribution reservoir, this is the main pipe and this is the sub main pipe. So the water is coming through this main and through this sub main under pressure. It is with the help of pump which have been used there at the supply or the we can say treatment plant. So here pressure ni pani ya tikani anla jato, and it will be filled inside this particular reservoirs, and from this reservoirs the water will be flow by the gravity. Okay, so we can say this is an combined system of flow. So where the pumping system is also used, and water be flow also by gravity gravity also. Okay, the radiating pipes are connected to the peripherals, hence the system works as a grid system without any dead end. Here also you can observe this radiating pipes or the laterals or the branch pipes have been connected to the periphery. So this is the peripheral pipe, so there is a no dead end in this particular pipe also. Okay, so water may again enter, excess water will reach to this particular peripheral pipe, and again it will meet to this main pipeline. Okay, so this was about the radiating system. Again, calculation of the pipe size are easy as compared to the grid iron system or the ring system. Now, dividing the area into entire zones ensure the equalization of the supply throughout the area. So as we have divided the entire area in different zones here, so the quantity of distribution of water will be same for the all zones. So that is equalization of the water supply will be maintained because of the formation of the different zones here. The zoning depends upon the population density, type of the locality, and topography of the area. So what if whenever we do the zoning or divide the entire city or town in different zones, so at that time different points or factors have been considered, has to be considered, and that factors are the population density, then topography of that area, okay, and type of the locality. If the topography of area is smaller and it contains the undulations there on the periphery of that, then that particular smaller portion will be considered as a zone. Okay, or if the population density for that particular locality is very high, in that case the size of the zone will be smaller because more water has to be supplied to that smaller area because of the higher population density. This method gives the higher service head and efficient water distribution. So this method is it gives the more efficient distribution of the water. So this was about the different layouts of the water distribution. Uday, Uday, okay. So we have to tell it from the beginning only, na? Whatever the things I was telling here. Up to which point you are facing problem? From which point or from the beginning only? Yes, Uday. Have you understood the first system, dead end system? Unmute yourself and speak.
Yes, sir.
Okay, you have understood this dead end system. What about the grid iron system?
Sir.
Have you understood this one or not? Uday?
Not.
Okay, I will repeat it in Marathi. See, Uday. हे पहिली जी सिस्टीम होती आपली विच सिस्टीम डेड एंड सिस्टीम. ह्या डेड एंड सिस्टीम मध्ये कसं आहे, प्रत्येक एंड जो आहे तो एंड हा कुठेही क्लोज झालेला नाहीये, हा सेपरेट एंड, याचा एंड इथंच झालेला आहे. ओके, त्यामुळे काय होतं, या ठिकाणी पाण्याचं स्टॅग्नेशन होतं आणि पाणी या ठिकाणी खराब होऊ शकतं पाणी साठल्यामुळे. ओके, स्टॅग्नेशन होतं म्हणजे काय, पाणी साठून राहतं याच्यामध्ये बिकॉज देर इज अ नो कनेक्शन विथ दी अदर पाईप. हे पाईप हा क्लोज केलेलं नाहीये. तसं बाकीच्या जी सिस्टीम आपण या ठिकाणी बघितले, बाकीच्या तीन सिस्टीम ज्या आहेत त्याच्यामध्ये काय होतं, आता हे ग्रीड आयन सिस्टीम जी आहे, ही ग्रीड आयन सिस्टीम जी आहे ती पर्टिक्युलरली कुठं वापरतो आपण, जे वेल प्लॅन सिटी असतात, जसं की चंदीगड सिटी आहे, ती कशी प्लॅन करून तयार केली सिटी आहे, त्याच्यामध्ये रोड्स हे असे पर्टिक्युलर रेक्टॅंग्युलर किंवा स्क्वेअर शेपमध्ये असे व्यवस्थित तयार केलेले रोड असतात. ओके, मग हे रोड असे ग्रीड पॅटर्नमध्ये तयार झालेले असतात. आणि आपण जनरली रोड हे जे डिस्ट्रीब्युशन नेटवर्क जे आहे हे कुठं असतं, आपल्या रोडच्या खाली असतं. ओके, हे पाईपलाईन आपण टाकली असते, त्यामुळे ऑटोमॅटिकली हे जे डिस्ट्रीब्युशन नेटवर्क आहे ह्याचा पण पॅटर्न जो आहे, रोडचा जो पॅटर्न आहे तोच पॅटर्न हा आपला वॉटर डिस्ट्रीब्युशन सिस्टीमचा असतो. ओके, मग आता ह्या ठिकाणी जर अशा पॅटर्नचे रोड असतील, ग्रीड आयन पॅटर्न जे रोड सिस्टीम जर असेल त्या ठिकाणी, तर त्या ठिकाणी आपली वॉटर डिस्ट्रीब्युशन सिस्टीम पण आपण असंच त्या ठिकाणी तयार करतो. ठीक आहे, आणि ह्या ग्रीड आयन सिस्टीम जे आहे याच्यामध्ये काय होतं, एक सेंटर लाईन मधून मेन पाईपलाईन या ठिकाणी रन होते, ही अशी मेन पाईपलाईन गेलेली असते. आणि ह्या मेन पाईपलाईनला या ठिकाणी सबमेन जोडलेले असतात, ह्या सबमेनची डायमीटर ही मेन पेक्षा या ठिकाणी लहान असते. आणि ह्या सबमेनला परत या ठिकाणी ब्रांच किंवा लॅटरल्स कनेक्ट केलेले असतात, परत ह्याची डायमीटर या ठिकाणी कमी असते. आणि या सिस्टीममध्ये जर आपण बघितलं तर त्या ठिकाणी कुठल्याही प्रकारचा डेड एंड हा आपल्याला या ठिकाणी पाहायला भेटत नाही. ओके, कारण हा प्रत्येक पाईप हा एकमेकांना कनेक्ट केलेला आहे, म्हणजे जरी या ठिकाणी वॉटर सप्लाय एक्सेस असेल तर तो पाणी आता पुढे जाईल. ओके, म्हणजे प्रेशर ओव्हरऑल प्रत्येक ठिकाणी तुम्हाला एकच प्रेशर आपल्याला पाहायला भेटतो, कारण ही क्लोज सिस्टीम आहे. पास्कल्स लॉ आपल्याला काय सांगतो, पास्कल लॉ आपल्याला काय सांगतो, इन क्लोज सिस्टीम द प्रेशर विल बी सेम एव्हरीवेअर. म्हणजे ह्या सिस्टीममध्ये काय होतं, क्लोज सिस्टीम असल्यामुळं एखाद्या ठिकाणी जर प्रेशर कमी असेल तर ऑटोमॅटिकली पाण्याचा प्रेशर या ठिकाणी फ्लो त्या ठिकाणी जाईल, आणि प्रेशर जे सिस्टीममध्ये प्रेशर आहे ते प्रेशर हे आपल्याला मेंटेन होताना दिसेल. म्हणजे प्रत्येक ठिकाणी आपल्याला सेम प्रेशर हा आपल्याला त्या ठिकाणी भेटू शकतो. आणि ह्या ठिकाणी यू कॅन ऑब्झर्व दिस डॉट्स आर नथिंग बट हे डॉट जे आहेत हे काय आहेत, दीज आर द वॉल्स आहेत, दीज आर द डिफरंट वॉल्स हॅव बीन प्रोव्हाइड हिअर. इट शुड बी स्लूस वॉल, इट हॅज बीन रिटन हिअर स्कोर वॉल, दीज आर नॉट ॲक्च्युली स्कोर वॉल्स. ओके, दीज आर द स्लूस वॉल यू कॅन सी. स्कोर वॉल आपण या ठिकाणी वापरतो कशामध्ये, या डेड एंड सिस्टीमच्या या ठिकाणी आउटलेटला, डेड एंड ज्या ठिकाणी असतो त्या ठिकाणी पायर बाहेर काढण्यासाठी आपण या ठिकाणी स्कोर वॉल्स हे त्या ठिकाणी प्रोव्हाइड केले जातात. सो दिस इज द ग्रीड आयन सिस्टीम. ओके, थ्रूआउट वॉटर इज सर्क्युलेटेड इन द सिस्टीम, अँड हिअर द मोर नंबर ऑफ वॉल्स हॅव बीन यूज, मोर नंबर ऑफ पाईप विल बी यूज. आता या ठिकाणी पाईप एक्स्ट्रा पट वापरले, आता हा एक कनेक्शन झालं या ठिकाणी, हे कनेक्शनसाठी आपण एक्स्ट्रा पाईप वापरला, ह्या कनेक्शनसाठी एक्स्ट्रा पाईप वापरला. जर हे पाईप नाही वापरलं तर काय होईल, हे डेड एंड सिस्टीम होऊन जाईल. म्हणजे हा जर पाईप आपण काढून टाकला तर काय होतं, या ठिकाणी डेड एंड सिस्टीम होती, इकडं इकडं पाईप्स असतील, लॅटरल जोडलेले असतील, मग हे या ठिकाणी डेड एंड तयार झाला, या ठिकाणी डेड एंड तयार झाला. मग या डेड एंडमुळे त्या ठिकाणी काय होतं, पोल्युशन ऑफ वॉटर इट मे ऑकर देअर. मग डेड एंड अवॉइड करण्यासाठी आणि इक्वल प्रेशर मेंटेन करण्यासाठी आपण हे एक्स्ट्रा पाईप या ठिकाणी पेरीफेरीवरती बसवलेले आहेत, हा दिस पाईप, दिस वन, दिस वन. मग याच्यामुळे काय होतं, सर्क्युलेशन, कंटिन्युअस सर्क्युलेशन विल बी देअर, देर विल बी नॉट डेड एंड विल बी मेंटेन. मग हे एक्स्ट्रा पाईप पण ह्या कनेक्ट केलेले आहेत आणि नंबर ऑफ वॉल्स पण या ठिकाणी आपल्याला जास्त पाहायला भेटतात, त्यामुळे दिस सिस्टीम विल बी मोर कॉस्टलिअर. ही काय होती, सिस्टीम ही थोडी कॉस्टली होते ॲज कम्पेअर टू द फर्स्ट सिस्टीम दॅट इज डेड.